Ever since I made the melee build video, each character since then I've been playing has had a certain melee build. And in that video I said I would do full build videos later on for a couple of them. If you've seen me in PvP over the last couple weeks, I can all but guarantee you that you've been seeing me on Top Tree Arcstrider with Assassin's Cowl. In today's video I want to talk about my complete build for it. It's really fun and I really hope some of you try it. The melees are happening more and more often, doesn't matter if you're in 6v6, comp 3v3, console, PC. And if you don't think that this works, it does. I encourage you to respect it because it comes fast and it comes in hot. You can use this very aggressively, or you can use it pure defensively. When you get close to another player or they get close to you, there's a chance now that with the shotgun nerf, the final blow is going to be a beatdown. It's going to be a melee. And also, once I go through everything that I have, if you want, at the very end of the video, I have about a 2-minute clip where I get a wee ran out of medals using the build. There are many, many ways to slot in your armor slots. For this first main version of it, I went all in. You don't have to. And as I go along through these mods, switches can be made, I'm going to bring those up. I'm going full force into the build, and you can see the idea behind it. I have a nice clip of it all coming together as well. Weapon-wise, that can change up a little bit. It can work with a number of weapons and loadouts, including one, a very odd one that I'm going to cover at the end. But I do have what I feel is the best weapon for it, but if you don't have it, there's some customization and you're going to do okay. The base, how I have these mods set up, works on all characters for a melee build with a desired exotic or skill tree. But certain things are going to change as you go character to character, subclass to subclass. What works really well with one won't work well with another, so you have to change it up. For this, it starts with Top Tree Arcstrider, where the warrior paired with Gambler's Dodge. Gambler's Dodge, dodging near an enemy, fully recharges your melee ability. In the tree, the most important part, Deadly Reach. Dodging increases your melee range. A way longer range, that further melee goes to combat flow. Melee kills recharge your dodge. Combination Blow, stacks to times 3, kill an enemy with this melee ability to get health regeneration and increases melee damage temporarily. It's 100% about the melee, it always has been. The Far Melee Lunge. You dodge before you get to your target, that way you get Deadly Reach procced. You get the melee final blow, that's gonna reset your dodge, and when you dodge next to an enemy, that's gonna reset your melee. Then of course, Lethal Current, while in super after dodging, arc staff hits create a damaging lightning aftershock. That brings us to Assassin's Cowl. Powered melee final blows grant invisibility and restore a portion of health and shield, so you get all three fronts. Within the tree, Combination Blow gets health regeneration. Assassin's Cowl gives health and shield, so four big things. With that charged melee final blow, you get health, health regeneration, shields, and invisibility. The invisibility lasts for 10 seconds, and a quick refresher, after 3 seconds, you're going to be off the radar. You can then jump, not double jump, walk around, crouch, walk, but the moment that you sprint, do an ability jump, so a double jump, or you're within 2 meters of your enemy, you're going to get back on radar. So once you're invisible, you're going to be on the radar at first. The only thing that you have is the invisibility itself, making it harder on your enemy to see you. But after 3 seconds, it's going to go off. You can use this time to plan. And the moment you do one of those things, the double jump, sprint, knee slide, get close, so you're going to show right back up. But that's just the radar. You're going to be harder to see. And when things get chaotic, there's multiple players, you're going to make a lot of things happen. You're going to be right in the thick of it. You get lost in the mix. You're going to ping at weird locations, weird times for your opponent. It's a very good thing. I have a 6-4-10-4-7-7 stat split. And I tried doing different things, all sixes with a couple sevens, couple tens in different spots. I tried different variations, but I went this route and I want to talk about why. The helmet itself, Arc, Assassin's Cowl, double hands-on, gain bonus super energy on melee kills. Like I said, I'm all in. You don't have to do that. You can only do one of these mods and then put on something like targeting. If you make the Assassin's Cowl void, you can put on Dynamo. Using your class ability, your dodge, within 15 meters of your opponent gives you some super energy. But since you're using the melee with the lunge, with the cowl, I do suggest at least one hands-on for your arc mod. You're going for melees, you might as well get some more super energy out of it. On the arms, Solar. Double impact induction. Causing damage with a melee attack reduces your grenade cooldown. Again, you don't have to do double, you can put on just one and then a reloader. And with this one, again, since you're going for and landing melees, it's the gift that keeps on giving. Aside from Solar, there is Void Arms, and that features focusing strike and bolstering detonation. The strike grants ability energy when you cause damage with your melee, which is good, so you can get your dodge to proc Deadly Reach, and then bolstering gives you class ability when you cause damage with your grenade. So skips, chase, they do damage. It's gonna be giving you your dodge ability back a little bit. The chest piece, this is a cleanup armor for me. I put on high energy fire, shotgun unflinching, and a big recovery mod. The boots, and look how perfect these boots are. Double shotgun scavenger, and before I get into the class item, I do have the Radiant Light, Powerful Friends, Taking Charge, High Energy Fire, the usual PvP charge with light build. On the class item, Solar with double bomber, reduces grenade cooldown when you dodge. So when looking at the stat split, one of these things is not like the other. I invested heavily into recovery, then intellect. Since I'm using double hands-on for super energy, I want my intellect to be a little bit high. I need my dodge and melee to be somewhat high. The odd stats out are resilience and the grenade. The resilience, I'm just gonna live with 4. That was on the lowest tier. But then there's the grenade. This entire build is around dodging, melees. So I did, however, incorporate the grenade into the build. Here's everything build-wise. I throw this grenade at 949 into the match. When I dodge after, double bomber on the class item is gonna proc to give some of that grenade energy back. I now have deadly reach ready to go for my melee lunge range. When I find my enemy, slug to the body, then a beatdown. This melee final blow, it has double hands-on, so I get more super energy. Double impact induction on the arms, so when I cause damage with this melee, I get the grenade energy. Then the tree, combat flow, this melee gives me back my dodge. So in 10 seconds, I have half my grenade back. And remember, I could dodge again, and double bomber's gonna proc again to get that grenade back. I get a lot of super energy, and if I was taking heat within that small space, I would have health, health regeneration, and shields. If no one was around, I could use the invisibility a little bit more. Then I could be off radar, hard to see, and go do it again. I love it. It's so good. This has been my favorite way to run this as far as mods, investing heavily into the melee final blow and then get rewarded for it to complete the build. Getting rewarded even more with my kinetic shotgun, Blasphemer. A swashbuckler slug is the best weapon for this build, for any melee build, in my opinion, currently. Or a swashbuckler reswalker. Swashbuckler sidearm. You don't have to have swashbuckler, but it makes the most sense because you're doing that melee final blow. I originally had Hipfire Swashbuckler, but I got Threat Detector Swash, and I like this one a ton more. After I get that melee final blow, I get health, shields, health regeneration, I go invisible. And now this slug does 200 to the body and can one-shot. It's potent. It completes it. Getting all those things, all those perks, and then getting to an opponent invisible with a body shot round loaded is crazy. It can and it will clean up an area easily. And with this setup, all those things can happen. Getting super, grenade, one-shot bodies, going invisible to your locations. And since you're invisible, a lot of times, even at a distance, you're gonna get first shot most of the time. And when you get first shot, you should win the duel. I pair my Blasphemer with Palindrome a lot, Stars in Shadow. And as a matter of fact, the gameplay here in a moment is an Outlaw Kill Clip Stars in Shadow, but you can use anything really. For your primer, aside from swashbuckler weapons, another nice one is Chaperone, Astro. There's nothing you can't really use. Like, it's funny how mostly you use Monte Carlo for the possible melee regeneration or reset, or to get melee energy, but with this, you're using it for the Markov chain. Basically, it has Swashbuckler built in. You can use Crimson, Rat King. Slot different things, try different things out, mess with it. Now, the third way is just a fun one for bow users. That's with Trinity Ghoul. Arc Final Blows get the Lightning Rod, so you're charged melee, skip grenade. You can do this purely defensive. Take bow shots at a distance, get the Lightning Rod, go from there, get some Final Blows. When you know someone is rushing, they're coming right at you, you're gonna dodge, get deadly reach proc. As they get close, you're gonna get way up in the air, fan the ghoul down on the ground, it's gonna do 151, and then you're gonna melee lunge in on him. You're gonna go invisible, that's an arc final blow, you're just gonna keep going and going. It's very odd, but it's kind of effective. I really do hope some of you try this or a version of it. There's a lot of power here. There's a lot of power getting all that from one melee final blow. Again, you can do it very aggressively like you see in the gameplay, or people are gonna come to you. It's Destiny, they're gonna come to you. Make sure you dodge before it. That way you have the lunge range, get up in the air, slug them in the body, come in for the melee. You're ready to go. Top Tree's neutral game with Assassin's Cowl is crazy good. Now for the last part of the video, like I said, it's a couple minutes. I do have a We Ran Out of Medals if you wanna watch it. If you're new here, remember to hit the subscribe button. And if you are subscribed, thank you so much for your support. If you're looking for a new controller, I am partnered with Scuf Gaming. Use the link down below and my code COOL at checkout for a discount. You can have some customization, but keep the base of the build together. Try it, have some fun. Thank you for watching, and until the next one, I am Cool Guy. Lost.
Zone A captured.
You continue to be my greatest success.